Marketing automation. We're going to be setting... Are you struggling to implement Zoho marketing automation? Well, if that's the case, then tune into these tutorials. What's up everyone, Casey here from Clientric. In today's tutorial, we're gonna be going over what Zoho Marketing Automation is, if you're not familiar. Just a very, very quick walkthrough of the entire system. It's going to be nothing too fancy, and we're gonna dive into a ton of detail as we go. We've structured it in hopefully such a way that it makes sense of how you'd actually wanna go about learning it. So make sure that you tune in to each and every video because each one is gonna be separate to something that marketing automation does. So let's log in and see what it looks like. Hey everyone, now that we're logged in, we can get started. So my screen here is what you'll see as the dashboard. This is everything you'll need when you log in. It tells you where you are in your journey, how many leads you have, you know, how many journeys you have. It'll be very descriptive as to what's going on when you start filling it out. So on the left-hand side here, this is our directional panel. This is where we can go in and we can click into the various different pieces and components of marketing automation. Within settings here, once you click this, it'll tell you all about all the different settings you can do. And we're going to be diving into this in a lot more detail. This is where you'd go to set up your senders, your domain authentication, and getting your system set up, which we'll cover in the next video. But for now, we're just going to leave this, and we're going to dive into a few of these other items. So lead gen over here, this is where you would create your forms, your lead sources, and it's a different component from campaigns. So this actually isn't in campaigns, because this is where you'd go about creating that lead generation side of things for marketing automation. Now, Web Assistant down here, this is where you'd go and add in your code. You can create different pieces of code, different ways of tracking individuals. We'll dive into this in a lot more detail. It's really cool, but for now, just note that this is where you go to create the code to put it on your website to start tracking more information about your visitors. Journeys, this is where we'll create lead journeys for our contacts, or maybe even it's a customer journey. This is where you push them into this journey and they have to follow through with the different steps as it goes along. So for example, if you're doing a lead nurturing campaign, as soon as someone comes into your business, they get the first email. It then tracks whether they have opened, clicked, or just not opened at all. And then from there, there's going to be a certain different set of steps that they need to follow in order to complete that journey. And you can make it as complex as you'd like, or you can make it as simple as you'd like as well. Now leads, this is essentially your contact book. This is where you are going to be keeping track of all your different contacts from CRM, whether it's syncing, or maybe you're adding them in manually, or maybe you're uploading a CSV, or some other method that they're coming into your system. This is going to be where you want to go, and this is going to be where you want to manage it and create different segments, maybe create different topics or products, and we'll dive into what each of these terms mean in the future. Just know that this is where you'll go to add more leads into your system. Now, when it comes to engagement, there is a ton of different types of engagement you can create here. Surveys, events, webinars, e-commerce engagement, email marketing, social campaigns, SMS campaigns. There are a ton of different things here. We're gonna dive into a lot more in the future, but just know this is generally where you go to create your email newsletter blasts or any other type of newsletter that you wanna send out to your contacts. The qualification funnel here, this is where we can add more information onto the contacts or leads to make sure that we are selecting the best ones, that we're not wasting our time contacting a lead or contact who is not going to be a good prospect. So you can add in different lead scoring techniques here. You can add in tags. You can add in stages and insights to those leads so it continues to track them as it's ongoing. And then the planner down here, this is where you can create different reports and you can also create your monthly or weekly planner, whatever it may be, so that you know what's going out when, and you can collaborate with your team in this as well and set up a proper plan to make sure that your contacts and your leads are continually being provided value by you constantly sending information out to them. Other than that, we do also have the library option down here, and this is going to be where you can upload images, templates, forms, attachments, anything like that. This is where you can constantly go in and grab them to use for your content when you create your email templates and your email newsletters and things like that. So this is a very brief overview of the system. We're going to be diving into each of these in a bit more detail as we go along, but just note that this is it. It's really simple once you get started. It might feel a little overwhelming at first, but we'll make sure that you feel prepared to tackle anything that comes up as we go through the rest of these tutorials. So we look forward to seeing you in the next one. make sure you subscribe below. We want to make sure that, you know, you're constantly getting updated with our new tutorials, our new videos, things like that. We want to make sure that we continue to grow our audience and help as many people like yourself out there as possible. So feel free to also join us on our other channels like Facebook and Instagram, and we look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye for now.